It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a shit about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
That's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah.
Just a gorgeous fall afternoon in the heart of Texas. No weather to speak of. Sun out, roof open. Yes, yes, and yes. A great day for football at AT&T Stadium in Arlington. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Seattle Seahawks and the Dallas Cowboys. A couple of 2-1 teams set to square off, and we're underway here in NFL Week 4. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Seahawks take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
And they'll come out with a three tight end look on the first play of the drive. Now the first carry here for Phillip Lindsay. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver, but he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front, so if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him, picks up three on that carry.
From the 24, Wilson, and the Cowboys pressure gets there this time for the sack. Stephon Tuitt able to shake free and get home for the sack. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Third and long, it's Wilson. He'll find Lindsay here. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. They do get seven out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. On fourth down, ready to punt, Michael Dixon. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. Fielded at the 20. A nice run back there off the good punt. It's a 16-yard return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10 at their own 37. And he is going to lose yardage here. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
Some of the big boppers in the game traditionally have been safeties, and he certainly fits that mold. He lets his pads do his talking.
A 3-yard loss to start the drive. They'll look to make that up and then some on second and 13. And, oh, he took that in one-handed. What a grab. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down.
Well, we know he has pretty good hands on display there. In fact, he only needed one of them.
Yeah, nowadays, all these receivers work on this, right? They do the one-handed catches off the machine in practice. They do it with their quarterbacks. They do it contested, uncontested. They make it part of their repertoire.
Looking to throw. Morrison. Blitz coming and And down he goes. Jordan Brooks in there to drop him for a six-yard loss, and that will lead to fourth down. On fourth down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. They only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. A 40-yard punt, no return, and it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
Then they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you called before, you realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
From the 27, Wilson. He finds Dorsett. It's complete. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. They'll run. It's Lindsey. And unable to get downhill there as he'll take this up to about the 37. Stephon Tuitt, the one that got him down.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. A really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Here's Wilson, looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Lindsey, and he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
First and 10, it's Lindsey. And he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory.
He's across midfield.
They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a 4-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
And they'll work this down to the 40-yard line. Tackled there. It's a first down on a gain of 10. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Now they'll throw it with Wilson. Steps away to his left. He's going to take off with it. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down.
Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there, not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Might have gotten this one down to the 28, and that's all. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
On second down, a run with Lindsey. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation.
We're scoreless after one.
The first quarter with no score.
Yeah, the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. Now it's Wilson. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down Seattle on a pickup of 13. They'll run here with Lindsey. And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. They'll get 13 yards for the second play in a row.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
From the two, here's first and goal. Here's a run with Balazs. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Kalen Balazs, his first touchdown on the year. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. A strong, determined run there, Charles, to get in for 6 points.
This is why it's such a team game, isn't it? And I know that sounds really generic and it sounds almost trite, but the blocks were made up front, offensive line, collective victory at the line of scrimmage and downfield. And how about the finish to the run all the way into the end zone?
And he'll be out of bounds across the 25.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And the last drive, their first drive, three and out. What changes here, if anything?
I think it's making sure the guys that you trust the most with the ball, the biggest playmakers you have, that they touch it on this possession to try and get things moving.
So get it to the horses.
Without a doubt. They're the ones that typically end up in the end zone.
Second and 10 now from the 27. To throw again, Morrison. He'll find his man on the comeback route, complete. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. The catch and run gonna wind up netting him 33 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll try the left side, McKnight. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
At the 43-yard line.
13 yards remaining on second down. Off the play fake. Morrison. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
But we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Gun. Morrison. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
There is something to a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest with a guy with that type of speed. You do so. Send him deep. Try and throw some air under it and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they run successful.
Gonzalez's kick is good. And that right there is something we've seen, oh, I don't know, 15 times in NFL history. That will officially go down as a 60-yard field goal.
And everything has to be absolutely perfect for this to have any chance. He's got to get it out low and really drive through it. And I tell you, that was one heck of a kick, one heck of a decision on the sideline to even try it as well.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
coming to the line here to begin their next drive. The Seahawks offense. They'll start on the ground with Lindsey. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
He was tackled at the 27.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
From the 27, Wilson under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Well, that play was the very definition of fast, quick, and in a hurry. Suddenly, he was there.
In a blink of an eye, that happened fast, and a big sack. Wilson of the Seahawks looking for something big following the sack. It's third and long here. From the shotgun, Wilson going for Metcalf. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Past the 20 and all the way in. Touchdown, Seattle. DK Metcalf. 79 yards. And the Seahawks are able to stretch that lead out a bit further. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear nine from the receivers, that meant fly route, go, look out. That was the nine, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23.
First and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. They trail by 10, 13-3 as they come up on a first and 10. And he got blown up on that play back at the 20. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
This defense is really flown around in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something else in order to try and get this running game going.
To throw on second down, Morrison looking middle, and that's complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
4-yard line.
Throwing on first down, Morrison. Going down the middle, and it's complete. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A big play there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Cowboys have cut it to within a score. The PAT good. It would draw him closer, but hold on just a second. A flag is down on the field. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Fielded in the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
Wilson, the Seahawks take over now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Trayvon Diggs getting the tackle. You don't see that a ton, do you? Or the cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
And he's got room.
accelerating, and off he goes. And all the way in, touchdown, Seattle. Philip Lindsay, his ninth touchdown of the season. And the Seahawks get the quick strike touchdown. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again and again and again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. A dangerous return man showing it here. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. There have been points on the board. We just saw back-to-back touchdown drives. I love it. I'm high-fiving our statistician, Christian McCloud, and you're angry. You're a defensive guy.
If you met one of my defensive coordinators, God rest his soul, I'm surprised he isn't in this booth right now wanting to really take you on. This is not football the way he sees it. He wants a good old-fashioned kicking game, defense, field position, and we're getting an up and down the field game here.
I'll take him. Where's his tombstone?
Boot Hill, baby.
They go play action here on first down. He's going to rifle one deep left side. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Shaquille Griffin with a pick.
Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They're starting to pull away with this one early on that first quarter. They didn't look so great offensively. What has changed?
Sometimes it's just a matter of doing what you plan to do better. Sometimes you just put that all together and you execute. Other times it's just in a simple adjustment in your game plan, finding a spot that maybe was a little weaker than maybe you thought, and going to that. So many different things, so many different ways, but right now, you gotta like what they're doing. They have put distance between themselves and their opponent.
Looking to add on here in the second quarter. The last run got a couple here, second and eight. Now Wilson, his throw incomplete. The intended receiver was DK Metcalf. And that takes us from second to third down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and eight. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
And the Seahawks, first down.
Shotgun snap and a give to Lindsay. And this will be a Seahawks first down as he's able to get this up past the 40. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Two first downs have them up to the 41 now for first and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. And now he's going to use his legs. The coverage may be too good that time as he breaks away for 19 with his legs and a first down. Now the Seahawks call the second of their three timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. On first down, Wilson. Throw left side, complete. It's Lindsay. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
4 yards on the pickup. Second and six.
A run with Lindsay out of the gun. And he'll work it inside the 30 to the 29-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
Now the Seahawks forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. Still a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they do get three before the half and expand that lead.
And they have to be happy about that. And we haven't met a team yet that doesn't put an emphasis on trying to get points on the board in the last 2 minutes of a half. They'll be real excited to have those up on the board.
That'll be taken about a yard deep. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. That's the reason we go for circle round twice for the encore. If you know, you know.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And you got to think, if this is anything other than just taking a knee, I'd be very surprised.
Yeah, they've got enough to talk about at the half. Why do anything else? Just get out of there.
And he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about a yard shy. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. Final shot before break. Morrison is going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. The Seahawks with the advantage, and they get the football first as the second half is underway. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
At their own 26-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They'll run on first down. McKnight, and from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Brandon, we just saw the benefits of being able to run the ball successfully. They pick up 4 yards on that carry. So now, if you're a play caller, you can do just about anything you want, but on the defensive side of the ball, you scramble a little bit. Now you're behind, trying to figure out, do I need to blitz him? Do I need to pressure him? How do I gain an advantage on this snap?
Two catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. They'll try the left side. McKnight, officially it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Looking to throw on second down. Morrison, he's going to fire one deep left sideline. This is caught inside the 15. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play here for Dallas. 49 yards. On first down,
McKnight, and he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. The excellent play last time is followed by a much more routine gain of 3.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Back to throw. Morrison. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. From 10 yards out. And the Cowboys draw a bit closer. That's the score you felt they had to have here in the 3rd quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard and you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And this carries into the end zone. And he'll just sit on this one as their drive will start at the 25.
Their own 25-yard line.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. The drive will commence with a run by Lindsey. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, 1st down.
And he continues to pile up the yardage. That puts him over a 150 now. And this defense has really had its problems trying to keep him contained.
On 1st down, right back to Lindsey. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. Now it's Wilson. Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys.
Zane Gonzalez lining up for
him. And Charles, look at the big fella. What a rumble that was. Not only to scoop it, but then take it the rest of the way for the touchdown.
And now you know they're going to have to hear about it from now on. The defensive backs, he's going to want to run with them, do their drills, the whole deal. He thinks he's the pace setter now.
It doesn't matter what happens in practice this week, he's smiling. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
5-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Their lead, they have seen it evaporate completely after such a good first half. They've been shut down here in the 3rd quarter.
Searching for answers, trying to figure out what it's going to take to get back to where they were before. The big part of it is that sometimes you don't have to go exotic now. You go back to basics. Being able to run the football, string some things together, some effective passes, try and get a rhythm established again, and try and get back in the lead.
Back in the lead, like you said, back to the basics. They'll break the huddle, come up on 2nd and 8 at the 27-yard line. Throwing is Wilson, looking for his running back, and he's got him. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. 23 yards the pickup there.
It's a game. But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
on first down. Lindsey. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 10 at their 49-yard line.
A third quarter now, to one-point game as they line up second and 10. Operating from the gun, Wilson. Open man is Jacob Hollister. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 32-yard line.
And the Seahawks.
A good pickup there of 20 yards. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 32-yard line. Here's Lindsey, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
On second and 12, Wilson going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see five wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
On third down, here's Lindsey. And they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26. Give him 8 yards on the carry, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
And it brings up fourth down.
And his kick is good. And with that, the lead changes hands here in this third quarter. So chalk that down as an 8-play drive capped with a field goal.
Yeah, as a friend of mine used to say, they were moving and grooving for a while, but they couldn't keep the momentum going enough to get a touchdown out of it.
Michael Dixon to kick off for Seattle.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken about a yard deep. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. Good drive last time. Really effective passing the football. Do you maybe mix it up, now go to the ground game and surprise the defense a little bit?
I would anticipate the defense making some changes, but I wouldn't necessarily just absolutely go in the opposite direction. They're doing so well throwing the ball.
Yeah, well,
I wouldn't change it up until they showed me a reason to do so.
To throw on second down, Morrison. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And that one almost intercepted. Morrison. Call it a 50-50 ball. It falls incomplete and now third down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by. And these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
He's got daylight. He's at the 30. 10, touchdown, Cowboys. A big play there, 77 yards. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even insult the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is the absolute production on the field. His second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Yeah.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now. First and 10 at their own 25-yard line. Now it's Lindsey. Yeah, this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. They'll go again with Lindsey. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage.
Taken down right now.
Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Second and 10 at the 42-yard line.
So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. For Lindsey, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That'll wind up as a loss on the play, so now they're staring at a third down and 12. Wilson. And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
We've watched this a long time, and I still don't believe we get it. Third and long, why are you calling play action?
Yeah, because they're not going to bite defensively, right?
No, not at all. I did have a coach explain to me years ago that for some teams, that's how they have to deal with pass protection and their line blocking. But to me, it seems silly.
Yeah, well, they're silly, and it leads to a play action sack. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And out will come the offense as they take over. 3-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
He continues to struggle to find a crease to break off a big one and might need to just put that aside and just try and ram his way forward and get what he can.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Now a man open down the middle of the field. Oh, now he's strapped. He lost the football. And the defense not able to get it. From a defensive perspective, what's that moment like when you realize the ball is loose?
It is a moment where all concentration goes right to the football. This is something you've talked about in all your preparation for the game. You probably talked about this training camp. Knock the ball free, take it away from the other team, and now you have that chance. It's a little bit of deflation when they end up recovering it.
They knocked it free, but couldn't take it away. Still 15 yards to go, second down. From the gun, Morrison. Now look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off near the 42. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. This game, it's been defensively oriented on both sides, so I guess it stands to reason that the play of the game comes on defense.
So it's my kind of game. You know that.
That's
anytime
right.
we have
that's
a defensive
right.
battle. But that, as you said, it stands to reason that's the way the game tilted. Someone had to make a big play, and the way the defenses were dominating, that's exactly what we got.
When's he going to try and run it in? And he will get into the end zone to extend the lead by two more.
34. Cowboys, 34.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air.
The Cowboys take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And they have to try and move past that pick six because now they're dealing with a fourth quarter deficit. And they need this drive to end in points. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Off play action, Morrison. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. That took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
The Cowboys on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 9.
56, Mike, 56, right there.
Looking to throw, Morrison. Will be incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
One score down, here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to rifle one deep, and that's caught inside the 35. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Big play there. His third touchdown of the game, number 9 on the season. And the Cowboys have once again taken the lead.
Extra point.
And that will make this a 4-point game.
He is good. Makes the score Cowboys 38, Seahawks 34. Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Taking it about the 1. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown. Their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Buying time to his left. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked up by Trayvon Diggs. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Boy, what a turnaround. They exited the lockers with a nice lead and now all of this. What's happened?
So when you start to write your novel, you'll start out with, it was a tale of two halves, won't you?
Right, but I'm a bad writer.
I don't know exactly what happened because sometimes teams can go in with a lead and get too comfortable, too relaxed, and a couple things go wrong, and it's hard to get back that good feeling.
On the pickup, 2nd and 6.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. They'll keep it on the ground. McKnight, and he's going to get this pretty close to a first down as the tackle is made at the Seahawks' 18-yard line.
Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Oh boy. A great play there. His 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Gonzalez now to have the extra point. And his kick is good, but flags come in. Looks like we're going to get a roughing call here on the follow-through. They're down here in the 4th, and that personal foul penalty's not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration, not a good play.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. Here comes Philip Dorsett now to return it. And some good special teams coverage as they bring him down just outside of the 15.
At their own 16-yard line.
Wilson and the Seahawks take over now, 1st and 10 at their own 16. Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Looking to throw again on 2nd down. Wilson, and this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
They tried the throw on 2nd down, unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. To throw is Wilson. Flushed out right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
No doubt that's a very good play defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
They'll try and throw for it with Wilson. He's going to let it fly. And no, it's incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. They'll run on 1st down. McKnight, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Brings up 2nd and 11 at the 21-yard line.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a 2nd and 11. Now it looks like he'll throw here. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it 1st and goal.
Well, remember, they tried to give him the ball and let him run on the last play, but I think the light bulb went off in their play caller's mind, and this time they get it to him the more conventional way, and it's much more successful as well.
And he will take it in for a Cowboy score. A great effort there with his 2nd TD of the game, his 6th on the year. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call. So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Zane Gonzalez set to kick off.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. This one fielded at the 5. And good coverage there on special teams as they'll get him down shy of the 20.
At their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Here's a give to Lindsey. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of four.
Brought down at the 23-yard line. A gain of four. It's now second and six.
Today's a big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.